I think social media is huge. It's affected me in loads of different ways. Of course, like, it's been a massive platform for me to reach out to people that have supported me along the way, and it's amazing in that aspect. But the pressure of it is huge, and sometimes I even worry for like my little cousins and stuff. I see how much it impacts them at school and how much they think is so important at school. Like, my little cousin says to me that the cooler kids are more cool because they get more likes on Instagram. Like, I just think it's absolutely mental that's what it is. It's hard for me to get through to them because they look at me and they see my Instagram, and that's why I get really stressed out, because they go to school and all their friends say, oh, your cousin's got this many followers and he does all this, can you get him to tap? It's like the cool thing in school. So it's something that they'll have to learn with age, but it is hard because as a person, like, so I'm a very sensitive person, and like, I try and build myself to be more resilient to kind of comments and stuff, but it's hard and it's something that takes time. But it's all good saying that we need to change everyone, stop being so negative, but you can't change the world in a day. I sometimes upload something and I see loads of negative things, and it does affect you and you get upset, and it also affects your mum, your dad. Like, I see how upset my mum gets when she sees things being said about her son. But I guess it's how you deal with it and realise that some of these comments aren't from people that matter to you and that important, and you can't let them affect you. If it was from your brother or your mum, your dad or your best friend, then you might get upset. But from a random person, then you can't. Otherwise, every time someone says something, it's just going to break you, and you can't live your life like that, because we live in a world the social media is controlling at the moment, really. I think what I've learned to do this year is to be able to take time off from social media. I don't try and fight against it all the time and say, I'm gonna do this, I'm gonna do that. I have my days where I use it and I enjoy it, and I'm videoing, I'm with my friends, and there's some days where I know how I'm feeling, I just take myself off from it and I won't use it for maybe a week. When I use it too much, you become too self-absorbed, you become too actually like selfish and worried about yourself all the time and worried about how you look and stuff. So this was in July last year. My mental health was just really bad at the point, and I just couldn't really deal with it, and it all just got on top of me at one point, and I just had a bit of a breakdown one day, and I said to my mum and my dad and my brother and everyone, I need to take a few days off. Like, it's just all got too much and I need to sort my head out first before I look at doing any work or anything. And then my brother, without telling me, messaged Chris and was like, Kem's really struggling, like, he's in a really bad place at the moment, like, he's not talking to anyone, like, what should we do? So Chris drove all the way down from Cotswolds, where he lives, and he was like, look, we need to do something. What do you want to do? Like, what do you really fancy doing? And I said, I just want to get away from everyone and just chill out, just us. We went to Centre Park and they were just trying to do everything to cheer me up, and it was working, but I was still really down. And I remember he bought a Batman and Robin outfit, and I think he was Batman and I was Robin, and he insisted that we was going to drive around Centre Park dressed as Batman and Robin and knocking on people's doors. And this is a photo of us kind of like perched up on bikes posing. And like, I was in a good mood, but I think I was just still really struggling. And in the photo, I looked like I'm all posing and having a good time. And we were in Centre Park's like two best mates living the dream. But at the time, I was going for a really, 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 really bad time. But luckily, after that weekend, I did actually start to get a lot better. The weekend did help me. But at that time, first day we got there, I was in a bad place. And as you can see, we dressed up, he's trying to cheer me up, but I don't know how much it was working. I'm a big overthinker, so when I'm struggling, it times is by 100, and I kind of put every negative option that would never even happen right at the top of my head, and all the good things that are happening around this time are like irrelevant. And I just think and I think and I think and I think, and I just get myself in such a pickle that it's only when it gets so bad that I have to take a step back and think, what on earth am I doing? But my head just goes at such a fast speed, I can't control it. That's why it's always, for me, important to take a step back and have my friends around me when I feel like that. Because when I'm in my own head, I shouldn't really be on my own, because I don't stop until I get really bad. I guess in certain aspects, it would have probably helped if I didn't have social media, but then I don't like to wish it away, because it's been a way for me to reach out and connect with all the people that have supported me for everything I've done. So I don't know, it's a weird one. I feel like it's such a big thing now, I can't imagine without it, but sometimes I think it'll be much better without it. So if we can control it in some ways, I think we can use it in a better way. Personally, I haven't had as much trolling as I've seen from other people. I think if there is ways that we can stop it, but not just for celebrities, for everyone. Like, I know the celebrities speak out about it, but they're not the only people that get it. I think everyone gets it, kids at school, boys, girls, older people, younger people, everyone. So if we can somehow, but like, get people together where they kind of feel like they don't need to do it anymore, because I don't know where they're getting it from inside them. They feel like they need to say these things to people. If we can kind of combat that, that will be a better option. If I'm honest, I think there's more being spoken about now about mental health than I've ever seen in my life. And I think it's important for people like us, especially like young guys like me, who have been through it, to be able to talk and go and get through to like the younger boys and girls, because it's a lot easier for us to get through to them, and it's a responsibility that we should take advantage of than like a guy that maybe studied in it. But it's harder when like a 45-year-old man comes to talk to a 13-year-old. It's harder to get through, but for us it's so much easier. This is why I'm really happy to be doing my school tour with Childline, something that I've wanted to do for ages but wanted to kind of make sure it was right. And we done the first one, and we've got plenty more to come, and it's an amazing project. I'm so excited to keep going and talking to all the kids, and they all really listen, and it's like, it makes me feel nervous because I feel under pressure, but at the same time, like, my message is getting through to them, and all I'm telling them is my story, and a lot of them in there might go home and take that and tell their friends, and it just escalates round. And this is why I'm so proud to be supporting the Where's Your Head At campaign. If you want to find out more and get involved, click the website below.